उसका पहले जो कुछ करना है कर, उसके पहले जो कुछ करना है पूरा कर सकते दिन भर में। और जहाँ बहुत परमानंद हो गया महामंत्र के बाद में, बस फिर अब गुरुदेव एक जगत गुरु, फिर परम गुरुदेव, फिर क्या
प्रभुपाद, फिर परम प्रभुपाद, नहीं क्या क्या, पहले गुरुदेव की वंदना, इसके बाद में श्रीगु चरण पद्म कृपा बिंदु दिया, ये सब कर लो, ये हो गया। इसके बाद में वैष्णव, इसके बाद में भगवान का कर करके हरि बोल खत्म। जैसे हम लोग का मठ में नहीं देखा है,
मठ में देखा है लेकिन यहाँ
यहाँ हम अपना अपनी धारा प्रवर्तित करना चाहते हैं। अज्ञान तिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानंजन शलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यै च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो नमो। महावदन्नाय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदाय कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्यनाम्ने गौरवत्तिषे गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकायै तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तदभक्ताय। यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहा पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदि तं सर्वभूतहृदयम्।
नंदगोपाल
एंड हिज फैमिली एंड ऑल्सो दुर्गन चले गए, निर्गुण प्रभु फैमिली एंड ऑल्सो द टू बॉयज
महाभारत
My boy is here.
Yes.
Oh, two are there. Your father has gone?
No. He's coming.
Where
tonight.
He is? He will come?
Tomorrow.
He will come here? Tomorrow. Oh, he is anywhere in job?
Yes.
Oh, why you are not sitting very nearer to me? Doing kirtan?
And shravan?
Playing? Don't be far away. Otherwise, Maya will take.
Kirtan come here.
Very near. Come near. But there you can sit there. Kya kar raha hai? You should take before that. By Bharatcharitra, the life history of Bharat. Srila Sukhdev Goswami has told a bit about Nivritti Marga. That how you should give up world and wife and everything, all kingdom like Bharat. And he, in three only births he had the prema bhakti of Krishna. Now he is telling that in this world whether knowingly or unknowingly, you are doing something. If you are sleeping, also doing something. Taking air.
Breathing.
And in breathing, lats and likes insects are killed. If you are walking, whether you are willing or unwilling, lakhs and lakhs insects and so many things will be crushed. You are taking water in that
water also.
In water also. And if you are doing knowingly, then nothing to tell. What they speak of that. So we are doing some wrong things, and that is called seeing. So in India, in Vedic knowledge, Vedic culture, it has been told that all should do five pancha suna yagya. If you are taking anything, first give it to fire. Some cows, some needy persons, and then take yourself. So you should try to do all these things. Otherwise you will have to test the fruits of these bad karmas. But if you are telling lie, cheating others, not serving your father and mother who has given birth, you are not doing for earth on which you are living and doing so much nonsense, digging, giving stool and passing urine to this, doing so much things. So sometimes for maintaining us, we kill so many animals. In America and our West countries, also in India, it is heavy to have fishing. They don't think that it is any sin, as if Krishna, God has created them for us, that we will finish fishing and taking. For hen, cutting. For goats, now cows. So in a sky there is nothing which cannot be taken. Only kite. One thing. Kite.
Aeroplane.
Aeroplanes and kites, they cannot. Or otherwise they will take everything. And in this
earth.
On earth what?
Everything except
all four
tables.
Trains.
Train.
Yeah.
Train.
Chairs.
Chairs will not they can take.
But in China, they eat also.
Rickshaw.
Not chairs.
Yeah, they eat a bicycle. Also.
In Guinness Book of Records, one person ate bicycle.
Yeah.
Wow. They take bicycle?
Yeah.
How?
Piece by piece. Piece by piece.
Huh?
They make it very small. They put it in restaurants.
No.
They take the metal. They take the metal. They grind it till it is like powder. Then they put it in their food mixing. Then they eat.
Also
yeah.
Glass. They eat glass as
yeah.
Well.
Right. So, so anyhow, we are bound to do some sins. But in India, there is prayaschitta.
Atonement.
Huh?
Atonement.
Atonement.
Yes.
Atonement. But these atonements are like a fire is burning in the bamboo
forest.
When it is the air is fire is extinguished. Then again from the roots some new
bamboo.
So many bamboo comes out like elephants. You can take the elephants to sea or anywhere in very good rivers, and they will take bath, and when they will come to the shore, they will take some
dust.
A person who has been given so much mud on his body, and if he is washing it by muddy water, will he be pure? What I told again?
If someone is covered with mud and then they take bath in a muddy river, they will not be purified.
No. So all the, what you told?
Process of atonement.
Process of atonement.
They are not enough. Only anyhow name is done. Abhas also. Abhas means?
Semblance.
Semblance. Then it will pure total. That is why he has taken Kechit Kevalaya Bhaktya Vasudeva Parayana Akhang Dhunvanti Karsena Niharam Iva Bhaskaram. It is so much dark with the fogs in morning. Everywhere fog, so dark. But as soon as sun will come, his rays will come, it will clear at once. So, like this, name is like Surya. Surya means sun. And all these sins are like fog. When Nami will come, we will chant name, all kinds of sins, ignorance, even the root cause of this avidya will go away. And that is why here he is in Srimad Bhagavat, Sukadeva Goswami is giving an
example
of Ajami. Can you? You can take.
Should I tell what Ajami was in his last life?
You can tell.
Briefly what Ajami was. So I'll just tell briefly what Ajami was in his last life, and then I'll come to this life. In his last life, Ajami, he was a very praka brahmachari and a brahmana. But in that life, he was very proud of his brahmacharya. And many people used to come and worship him. And he used to, after some time, appreciate the worship. And he thought that he would do more austerities and become even a greater brahmacharya. So he submerged himself in icy water. He submerged himself in icy water.
In
his last life.
So where it is written in Bhagavatar, where?
My god brother told me from one Purana he has on palm leaf. Ajamil's last door.
So first you should tell what is written here
life.
And then after that, why has Ajamil
come? Oh, okay. So Ajamil, as a young boy.
Ajamil.
As Ajamil.
No, Ajamil.
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 As a young boy, he was also very Paka Brahmachari. He knew all Vedic scriptures. He was very well behaved. He was celibate. He knew how to respect guests and elderly people. And his father always engaged him in deity worship and Brahminical activities. And one day, as he was going out getting paraphernalia for deity worship,
he was also married.
Yes.
Not Brahmachari, he was.
In his young age.
Young age he was married.
When he went for that
he was married. Children.
He was not in house, unmarried, but he was married with a very chaste and qualified girl.
children.
And he has also some children.
Yes. So when he was married and he had some children, he had a very chaste wife. he went out to serve his Gurudev and he saw a...
Huh?
Service of Gurudev, not father.
Service of Gurudev.
No.
Father.
Father.
Yeah.
Service of father.
He went to collect some dry wood for his father's...
For the fire sacrifice.
You also try to read yourself this literature. And then dare to speak.
Some small points I left out.
So try to be very... Okay.
So then we get to the stage where he finally meets the prostitute, shamelessly embraced by a sudra.
How he met?
When he went to the forest to get the firewood for his father's fire yagya. And the woman, she had turmeric on her body also, which agitates her mind even more. It's one of the tricks a woman has of agitating her mind. So he also became very agitated, it says in the Bhagavad Gita. We see in India that many women, they smear turmeric in their bodies.
You also track lesions.
So...
And then weep.
Instead of laugh.
So like that, his mind got agitated and he lost... He forgot all the things, all the good instructions that he had learned from his father and from small boy. He forgot everything and he fell down with that prostitute. And he led a life of very sinful activities. He would steal from people and he would do all nonsense. He would gamble anyway to get money by hook or crook to maintain the family. Because after some time, he had many children to this prostitute.
He stole away all the wealth from his father, mother, and he gave it to
prostitute.
How he captured, she captured. She captured him. First, when he could not check, control his senses, especially lust. Then it took so many gold and everything, and one to give and to control that lady. But she took everything, and he used to give him so much wine.
Wine.
So much wine. And taking wine, all intelligence and everything
went.
And so much lust came that he gave himself in the to the that prostitute. But
Ajami, before fall down, he tried to remember
control.
I am a Brahmana. He tried to do. He tried to get salvation from this.
So it has been told that you should not see a naked wooden
doll
also. Whether it is of any male or female, don't look after. It will attract your minds.
He tried to get salvation from this.
And
person.
You cannot check and control at that time. No? So better not to go. Don't take wine. Follow four basic principles. And then go on.
So, because he saw this woman, he lost all his intelligence and he fell down with her and he engaged in all sinful activities and he had...
And she used to chastise him. Bring more. And because he was so much lusty, he was controlled by that. Then he has no money, then he used to go to store.
Steal money
by dacoity, by cutting others,
murdering.
By robbing, anyhow, by crook and go on now.
Actually, one time Srila Prabhupada heard on the tape that if a man and woman they're married, and if someone comes to steal their money, the man will have them arrested by the police. But if a woman comes to take all the money, the man will think, oh, I have a very good wife. So,
yeah.
Prabhupada told.
I don't understand.
That a man and woman are married. If the wife comes and takes money from the pocket, the man will think, oh, I have a nice wife. But if someone comes to rob money, they will call the police. But the wife is doing the same job.
तो अगर कोई आदमी आके पति का पैसा चुराता है तो वो उसको पुलिस में खबर करके उसको बंद कर देता है लेकिन अगर पत्नी पैसा पॉकेट से पति के मारती है और इकट्ठा करती है तो पति जानते हुए भी ये कहेगा ये मेरी अच्छी पत्नी है
अच्छा नो गो ऑन
सो लाइक दिस अजमल ही पास्ड ऑल हिज इयर्स थ्रू ऑल दिस सिंफुल एक्टिविटीज And he finally became old, and in his old age, he had a son. And because in his childhood, he did a Shalagram Shila worship, that name of Narayan was still in his heart from small boys. So somehow or other, Krishna within his heart prompted him to call the last child, the seventh or eighth child, Narayan. So the time of his death came to Arjamil, And because he was so attached to this small boy, Narayan, whenever he took food, he called the child to take food. And whenever he took water, he called that boy to come and take water. And he was always calling him Narayan. So throughout his life, the Bhagavatam says that he'd already chanted Namabhas by chanting his son. And it says that there's different kinds of Namabhas, one who says jokingly to indicate something else. Or in a musical way, then it forms Namabhas. And by Namabhas, all of one's sinful activity, it says for millions of lifetimes, were already atoned for. So at the time of death, he yelled out Narayan, because that was in his heart. And three Yamadutas came because he committed sinful activity with his mind, with his speech, and with his body. So when they came there, immediately the Vishnu Dutas came because they called the name of his master.
Immediately came or they began to take his soul.
Bind his soul up.
And he was crying like and weeping. At that time,
by fear,
he saw his child. And
then Narayan's four Dutas came.
While they were binding him, he was very fearful and crying in a distress.
And so, at that time he called.
Then he saw his child and called his child as Narayan at that time.
So when the Vishnu Dutas came, the Yamadutas, they saw these four effulgent personalities and they were shocked at why they're coming there to a place where this sinful Ajamil was. And so they started to have a conversation that what is religious principles? And if you know what is religious principles, why have you come here? Because he's under the jurisdiction of Yamaraj. He's not under the jurisdictions of Vishnu or Narayan. So then a dialogue took place. And they told him that because he called the son of Narayan our master, then he's come under our jurisdictions. You cannot touch him. So within the minds of the Yamadutas, they were starting to think that I thought that Yamaraj was in charge of justice. Now I'm hearing that someone else is higher than him. So then after that they had a conversation, what is religious principles? And then they
want to tell what was discussion. It is important.
The discussion was that the Vishnu Dutas and the Yamadutas, they came to a conclusion, who is under the
Not conclusion.
The Vishnu Dutas told who is under the influence of Yamaraj, and they said one who has never once chanted the holy name of the Lord, or who has never visited a holy place, who is engaged in sinful activity. One who is engaged in sinful activity and who has not followed religious principles or engaged in any of the regulated principles mentioned in the scriptures, he comes under the jurisdiction of Yamaraj, and one who even in some way follows the path of religious principles, he doesn't come under the influence of Yamaraj, the superintendent of death.
Go on.
What after that?
Oh, that. Yes, so tell after that.
So after that, just when they tell what is the. They established that Narayan is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and that Yamaraj is under his... No?
You forget, Jagadish, Ajamila gets salvation.
Can you tell?
Ajamila gets salvation.
Mohana.
Ah, Jajana.
Guruvai.
Hare Krishna.
What was the dialogue? I don't... What was the dialogue?
Ajamila gets salvation. His life was a very sinful life, but he gets salvation only because he never made a Vaishnava aparada. It's only for this.
No.
Bhagavan.
No? I am telling what was the dialogue between them.
I know, but I have to make order now. Because
so
my
you
mind
should
is...
go and first hear and then. You can? Oh. What name?
Prem Prayajan?
Where is Prem Prayajan?
He's coming.
Can you tell?
So, here, Vishnu Dutas, they came, the Yamadutas, the messengers of the Lord of Death, Yamaraj.
More loudly, please, louder.
They came, and they were very ferocious, with their teeth sticking out, and their hair standing on end, and very black and ugly and deformed. And three of them came.
So many nails, so big
nails. And they came with ropes. And they bound the throat of Ajamil and began to drag him out from his body. So that time Ajamil was so terrified and he called out in great horror, Narayan, with mind fully absorbed in the name of Narayan, though he was calling his son. So that time, four Vishnu Dutas, the messengers of Lord Vishnu, they appeared there, most brilliantly effulgent and with gold crowns and this club conch. Lotus flower, they appeared there and began to threaten the Yamadutas, but let him go, can't punish him. The Yamadutas were so astonished to see someone obstructing their activities, because this is what they do.
They told, do you know what is dharma or what is adharma? What is right and what is wrong, you know? Then, yes, we know.
So,
then can you tell? Then they began to tell.
Yes.
What Jamduta began to tell?
So, the Yamadutas, they said to the Vishnudutas, how do you have the audacity to stop us from taking this very sinful person? Because in this world, everyone is performing, knowingly or unknowingly, sinful activities. So we shall take him. But then the Vishnudutas said...
What sin he has done, he told.
The Vishnudutas said to the...
No. Mm. Oh. Mm. Can anyone? Prabhu? Urukram? Or you want to hear?
We want to hear.
You have read thoroughly? Tumi? অন্যথা ফের আবার তুমি ওই রকম রাগ ধরব ন ইউ শুড হিয়ার আই নো দ্যাট ইউ ক্যানট টেল বিষ্ণু টোটাল টোল দ্যাট হোয়াট আর ইউ ডুইং ননসেন্স ডু নো হোয়াট ইজ রিলিজিয়াস রিলিজন অর ইন রিলিজন ধর্ম ধর্ম আর অধর্ম ও ইয়েস He was a very good Brahman son, always doing right things. He learned Vedas, all the Vedic culture. And when he became young, he was married to any chaste ladies. But being in bad association, he has left his chaste wife and children. He had left her all good activities, fire sacrifice, serving father, mother, everything. And after that he began to take wine to cut animals and all others, human beings. He had murdered lakhs and lakhs persons also. And he has taken and he has looted all money from them. In this world there is no sin that he has not done. All kinds of sin. He had not even repented for this. He had not done prayaschit.
Atonement.
Atonement also. Nothing. So, we are ordered from Jamdev to take all the persons like these souls, bad souls, and to bring to Jamale and to get so much pain for their bad activities. So we are right and we have come to take this. Then Vishnu Dutta told, I think that you don't know anything. All the beings of this world are sleeping, giving their heads on the lap of Jamdev, that he will do right, he will never do wrong. And you have been sent by him. I think that you have not been sent by him, but you are doing wrong thing without his order. You know that at the time of death, willingly or unwillingly, he has chanted the name of Narayana. So he, all kinds of bad activities, sins, even he has murdered hundreds and thousands. He has looted. He has taken wine. He has left his father, mother, and served a prostitute. And for this he has apna jivan bekar kar diya.
Spoiled his life.
But even he has told one time, when he uttered this name, and he kept this name to his boy, first time, all his sins has been gone away. And now what he is telling, oh Narayan, bring water, bring this, that. Oh, kissing him, oh, Narayan is very good boy. These are repetitions of names, that is, this is practice of bhakti yoga. But why he is doing? So none says, after keeping his name, Narayan, and he again began to murder and doing all these sins. Oh, after taking this name, what he is doing, activities, they are like burnt rope. If any rope is there and it is burnt in fire, even the crookedness of rope is seen there, but it will not act anything. Anything cannot be binded by that rope which has been burnt. So his all activities are burnt without any result. Who can see it? Who are realized? They can see this, but general people cannot. Oh, they will see that he is going on. That is why in Gita it has been told, apichetsu duracharo bhajate imam ananya bhag sadhu reva sammantap samyak vyavastohisa. If anyone doing apichetsu duracharo, doing so much nonsense things, but ananya, taking name of Krishna ananya bhavena, means
with single-minded devotion.
Then you should think that he is really a sadhu. Even he is doing, going on. Because his all sins and everything has been burnt. You should see him like a sadhu. Because after some days, chipram bhavati dharmatma swachha chanti nigacchati. Patijanahi.
Kaunteya.
Kaunteya. Kya?
They have the jani.
My bhakti cannot be what?
Vanquished.
So, we should know like this. If a devotee chanting, remembering, but by weakness he has come to a family life, we should not criticize them. But don't have association of that kind of bhakti. Never, never. Like be like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But don't criticize. Chipram bhavati dhatmatma. He will surely, if he has not offended any nam aparad, he has not insulted Vaishnava's guru and other things, very soon he will quickly again come out. When quickly? What is the meaning of quickly? If in this unlimited time, if we are taking hundreds of birth, it is very quickly, very quickly. Because there is no end of this life, taking birth and life. If in 100 births we are being, no harm. But he will chip from our next life, like Bharat. He may be pure. So don't criticize. But if anyone is so innocent, following the Vedas, and doing so much good things, never speaks lie, and he serves father, mother, and he is doing accordingly all the Vedic culture he is following, but not chanting name. We should not associate, and you should not think him sadhu. Never. So here he is telling that Vishnu Dutas, that fan he took first, he gave the name of Narayan. At once, his all sins have been burned. Before no action.
Before and after.
Before and after and for future. All. But if he will think that by uttering the name of Narayan or Vishnu, Krishna, if my all sins will go away and has gone away, so I can make some more sins, and again I will take name, and again
it will go away, sin will go away.
Then it will be nama aparad.
Nam bole papu.
Then Krishna will not forgive him. Name cannot forgive.
This means without knowing the glories of name, he was chanting the name. So name was effectual on him.
Yes.
If we understand the glories of name, and then we do sinful activities.
None. Then it will be nama aparad. So you should try to know these things very. He has no nama aparad. Nothing. He was simply doing all these sins. He had not known the power of name, power of Vishnu bhakts, devotees, or Krishna. No, he had not criticized, offended any Vaishnava or Krishna name or any of the 10 nama aparad. So he is telling that even he has done so many wrongs, he has chanted name Narayan. He has chanted the same Narayan name in his last life, last breath, when they were taking and bending and taking him to Yamaraj. And he told Narayan. So Vishnu Dutas are telling, all kinds of sarvesham api aghavatam idam eva sunishkritam nam vyaharan Vishnu jat tad vishayamati. That when only by taking the name at that time, all kinds of sin, murders and so many things, going to prostitutes, disobeying his father, mother and wife, not supporting his children, all went. So He has done everything, he has completed everything in his life. Nothing to do any
atonement
for
he,
this.
He has done his atonement completely.
Completed. But only this you should remind. Like Jagai Madhai Bole, Ar Nare Bap. Ar Nare Bap.
Prabhu Bole, Tura Nakuri Sre Bap, Jagai Madhai Bole, Ar Nare Bap.
When Jagai Madhai came in the Sharanagat Hua,
shelter of Nityananda Prabhu,
took shelter in the lotus of Nityananda Prabhu and Mahaprabhu, then Mahaprabhu ordered them, Ar Nakuri Sre Bap, don't do any evil things. All kinds of sins. And they took their hands on their
ears.
And they, unhone kasam khai.
Promise.
Take vow.
That in our life we will never do like this. Never, never, never. Three times. And at once quickly Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave prem in their hearts. And they began to weep, oh Krishna, oh Krishna. Surfacing like ghats, they began to broom and to become and to do so many best ghats, so clear and honoring all devotees at once. So Vishnu Dutta are telling that he has done everything. Not he is not papi, but Vishnu. Jamadutta were in doubt that he took name and after that he again did so many. Vishnu Dutta are telling by name, past, Vartaman,
present
and future, all kinds of sin will go away. So don't think about this. But they were not satisfied. Who are you? We are Vishnu Dut. We have no power to interfere in this. And saying this, they began to again bind the soul of Ajami. Then Vishnu Dut took their arches,
swords,
and
weapons,
and defeated them, and thus they ran away. And went to Jam and told,
Lalaiva.
Then they defeated them and they at once ran away to Jam Maharaj and complained against them. Up till now you have known that you are the sole creator and what?
Supreme
personality of Godhead.
Supreme controller.
But we see that you are not like so. Someone came and they interfere in our this
service.
Then what became? He told, oh, they told the whole story. Then he told, he did namaskar. To whom?
Narayan.
To Narayan, Supreme Personality. And he told, oh, we have not told all these things to you before, but I am under a supreme controller, and Narayan is supreme controller. Jam Maharaj has no connection with link with Krishna, supreme personality in Braja. Like constables.
Constable.
They can be in control of Havaldar, Colonel, and SP only. They have nothing to do with IG and President, and they are not in touch because they are very small, in
service.
Small positions. Chowkidar in villages, very low position. They have nothing to do with high ranks of persons. So, Jamaraj is always in connection with Narayan. So he is telling that my controller my worshipable is Narayan. And only wish, some we know all the deepest thoughts of religion, Vedic culture. Who? Swayambhu, Narada, Shambhu, Kumara, Kapilo, Manu, Prahlado, Janako, Bhishmo, Bali, Vaiyasaki, Vayam. Dvajas ete bijanimo dharma bhagvatam bhata guhyam vishuddham durubodham te jnanam ritam asute etani var lokesmin punsa dharma parashmita bhakti yogo bhagvati tannam. There are 12 persons. They are Mahajan. When he was telling at what time? In Satya Yuga. But now more prominent Mahajan are here. Who are they?
Rupa Goswami.
More important, more prominent. So he is telling the of our Satya Yuga. Swayambhu, Brahma, Narad, Mahadev, Shankar, four Kumars, Kapil, Manu, who has written Manu Smriti, Prahlad, Janak, Bhishma, Bali Maharaj. He left his Gurudev, who was against Krishna service. Vaiyasaki, Vyasing Mane?
Sukhdev
Goswami. And Vayam? Who I am? Myself.
Jam Maharaj.
We know the deepest meaning of
religion.
Other not. So, in this world, etaneva lokesmin punsa paradharma, smita, bhakti yoge bhagvati tannam grahanadivi. So, in this world, for human being, for all living entities, only one dharma is then religion, for to chant the name of Krishna. And others, adivi here, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Padashivanam, Archanam, Bandhanam, Dasram, Sakra, Atmanivedi. All these things. Very powerful. So he has done everything he has done everything. So you should not go to them. Jivan Bhakti Bhagavat Guna Namadheyam Chetaschana Smartacharnaravindam. Krishnaya no namati jatsira ekadapi tan anayadham asato akrit vishnu kritya. In this world, though they have served father, mother and did worldly very good activities, but jivana vyakti bhagavan gunnamadheyam, those who turn not always uttering the name of Krishna, and who is not always meditating the pastimes of Krishna, and jiva not uttering the name of Krishna, and the person whose head is not
prostrated at the lotus feet of Krishna,
not doing pranam to Krishna, or deities, or to devotees, even devotees. Tan anottam. You should go and bring all living them. Those who are chanting name, who are hearing Bhagavat Katha, those who are doing archan to Bhagavan, don't go to them. Even they are chanting Namaparat, you cannot go to them. They are
under control of Vishnu.
Vishnu, not under me. Whether he is doing Namabhas or Namaparad even, Krishna will control them. You are not, I am not that authority. So you should not go to them. Those who have taken Kanthimala, and they have been initiated, whether this initiation is wrong or right, no harm. Vishnu mantra has been given, and he chanting name. Don't go. If at the time of death, they are touched with Tulsi lips, Bhagavat Pothi, the book of Srimad Bhagavatam, Gita, and any devotee he has come and giving Ganges water or Tulsi attached to his body anywhere, don't go there. Otherwise you will have to be punished. Then he did pranam and he returned. But when he was saved from death and he heard all the dialects very patiently, oh, how wonderfully I am saved from this death. He wanted to touch the lotus feet of four Vishnudut. Who are four Vishnudut? Na, Ra, Ya, Na. Four letters were four
messengers
of Vishnu. So he wanted to touch their feet. You have saved me. But at once they disappeared. Then he took his life and he went to Haridwar, where Ganges comes in land from hills side. And there he took bath. And any place he began to chant the same name what four messengers of Narayan has told, thinking them like their his bona fide guru. Om Narayanaya Namah, Om Bhagavate Vasudevaya, like this, and he began to chant. After his heart has been cleared by taking the darshan of these four messengers of Vishnu and hearing the seeing this scene there, he has a very strong faith on name, that if my name was not pure, even I have been saved by this, then if I will chant this pure name only to serve Narayan, then there will be very more
benefit.
Now he took his mind intelligence one-ended. Nothing to remain of his life. One name chanting, weeping, Narayan, Narayan, Narayan. And after some days, when he received some prem, Adu Satta Tata Sadhu Sangha, he galloped something. At once Nishtha came, and from Nishtha Ruchi, and Ruchi to Asakti, and then Vishnudut again came. Told that everything has been successful. We have come to take you to Vaikuntha. At once, they took Ajamil. He gave up his body, this material body, transcendental body came. What was here, and they took it on the
airplane.
Man, transcendental airplane.
Vima.
And the two at once event. So we should have very strong faith in this God's name, Narayan and Krishna name, or any name, Jagannath. But there are three kinds of name. First two kinds. The names of Krishna which are connected with this world, like Jagannath, Jagannyanta, Ishwar, Paramatma, all these names are second class of name. And Shuddhanam, primary names, are divided into two. First, where there is opulence in these names, like Nishingha, Baman, like other names, Narayan, they have opulence. And those who have sweetness of Braja connecting, they are more powerful. If you are chanting name of Narayan, you can go to opulence with Vaikuntha. And if you are chanting Sri Krishna Govinda Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishore Krishna Harshi Yasoda Tanaya Prasida Harshi
Yasoda Tanaya Prasida
Sri Vallabhi Jeevan Radhike Shri Vallabhi Jeevan Radhike Shri Krishna
Govinda Hare Mukunda Govinda Hare Nanda
Krishna Gopala
Hare Mukunda Govinda He Nanda Kishore
Krishna Harshi Yasoda Tanaya Prasida Shri Vallabhi Jeevan Radhikesha Like this Vallabhi Jeevan Mane Gopi Jana Vallabh And Radhikesha Radhanath Ha Radhanath Like this. All these names are supreme, sweet, and supreme, powerful. Even then, Narayan, if you are taking the name of Vishnu three times, 1,000 times, then it will be equal to Ram, one. And if Ram three times, then it will equal to
one
Krishna name. It has been given in. There are so many reasons, scientific reasons, vigyan sammat causes. Krishna has 12 rasas, but in Narayan and Vishnu, 1,000 parts like Krishna name. No rasa, nothing. Santakaram bhujagasainam
padmanabham
suresham Like Santakaram. Where he is? In Karanadishai. What he is doing? Nothing. He is sleeping. Only breath is coming. And Lakshmi is
massaging.
And their prakriti is in samyavastha. No activities of any satarajatama. No, also Chidguni is there, nothing else. And there by Tatastha Sakti, so many jivas are coming. Some are going there, some are going here. So, Santakaram. But in Narayan there are 1.5 rasas. Shanta, Dasya, and half of anything. It may be of
Kamala, Lakshmi ji jo unke pair se baat.
So only half. And in Ram, Ram is distant. These three, these half, 2.5 are also in more quantity and quality.
Ram
extremely pathetic.
Shanta, Dasya, half of Sakha and half of Vatsalya also. And some madhur, partly madhur, manishvakiya. So he is somewhat same Narayan as Ram, but there is some difference in rasa. And Ram has these qualities, but Krishna, all the 12 rasas, he is object of 12 rasas. Ram is especially is the deity of Karuna rasa. Karuna Rasa, and he is of all. So, three times more than Narayan name, or Ramna. So, in Krishna name also, there is some
gradation.
And what is in this? Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna Govinda. Govinda, this name has been given by Indra. Always grazing cows, supporting cows. So Govinda, Krishna, the son of Yashoda Maiya. Govinda, Shri Krishna, Govinda,
Gopala,
Hare, Mukunda. And then,
Govinda
He Nanda Kishora Krishna, Hasi Yashoda Tane, the son of Yashoda Devi, first Nanda Tane. Yashoda Tane is somewhat
superior
than Nanda Tane. And from Nanda Tane, Yashoda Tane, Ballavi Jivan means beloved of gopis. And after that, Sri Radhika is more superior. So Radhanath, Radha Govinda, Radha Madhav, these names are so sure. If anyone doing Radha Ramana Hari Govinda, Radha Ramana Hari Govinda, Govinda Jaya Jaya. Radhanath, Nanda Kumar, Yashodanandan, and Radhanath, if anyone is calling Radhe, 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 then Krishna will donate everything, will give everything. Fully he will give. So, Vaishnav, no, Hare Krishna, Hare means Radhe. And if Krishna, Hare Krishna, then Krishna mane Radhe, so Radhe Radhe. And Hare Ram, Hare Radhike, and Hare Rama, Rama means? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare. Only Radhe, 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 Radhe. Anyone can do, but especially not all. Not are qualified to do this. So we should chant Hari name like this. All sins will go away. Then then he began to tell the charitra of Vritrasura, Chitraketu Maharaj. Who was Chitraketu Maharaj? And who was this Vritrasura? Indra has done some mistake. He killed any Brahmin. And thus, when he was killed, then his father made a sacrifice. What he was telling? What he was telling?
Indra Satra Vivarasa.
What is it? You should come and tell.
When Indra killed Vishwarup, that means son of Tvastra Rishi. Vishwarup, mother dynasty was demon and father dynasty was demigods. So during fire sacrifice, he was doing swaha swaha, louder and louder for demigods. Sometime being silent, being low voice, he did saha for his mother dynasty. So Indra came to know this fact and told, oh, he's so silly, so
cheater.
Tricker, cheater. he is doing soha for his mother dynasty also. That means demon will be developed. So at once he came and killed Vishwarup, that Brahmin boy. So his father Tostaris, he became furious and he did one fire sacrifice. His inner mood that I want a son who can kill Indra. But she uttered the Vedic mantras, Indra
with some defect.
Indra Satra Vivardhasa. But there is some defect. Indra Satra Vivardhasa. That means who will kill by Indra, he will be get up from this fire sacrifice. He wants that killer of Indra must come from this fire sacrifice due to bad pronunciation, and he traced some different word. So who will be killed by Indra, he came out from fire sacrifice. He was Vritrasura. In his first birth, first life, he was Chitraketu Maharaj.
After that, you should do all these things.
Chitraketu.
After that, when he will be killed, then.
Then it was asked, who was he?
Who was he?
Why he went demon and he is doing like.
He came from fire sacrifice and he challenged Indra. There is a great battle took place there. Indra tried to his best to kill that Vritrasura
with his
thunderbolt.
But he could not.
But he could not do so. He told, you are insignificant. You could not kill me. Only by his own effort.
ऊपर झापर से ले लेते हैं थोड़ा सा पढ़ना चाहिए मैन्यूटली तब तो होगा
दधीचि की हड्डी का बना हुआ
भजन है द नारद इंद्र एंड हिज ऐरावत गोए फ्रॉम फार अवे फ्रॉम Vritrasura इंद्र फेल डाउन फ्रॉम हिज ऐरावत
व्हाट ही टोल्ड
फ्रॉम हिज ओन एफर्ट इंद्र फेल डाउन व्हेन Vritrasura
नो व्हाट ही टोल्ड यू अंडरस्टूड आई कुड नॉट
His elephant and Indra fell down.
Yes, when he hit him.
Okay, tell.
He fell down and told, oh Indra, you could not, why you are so far away? Please take your thunderbolt and kill me. Then Vritrasura praying for God.
Why? He told that he cannot kill me.
Because Indra could not kill him, better I can pray for God. He is telling that Aham Hare Tava Padaika Mula Dasanu Daso Bhavitasma Bhuya Manas Mare Tasu Patir Gunanam Granita Bhakkarma Karo Tukaya Aham Hare Tava Padaika Mula. Oh God, I am servant of your lotus feet. Aham Hare Tava Padaika Mula Dasanu Daso Bhavitasma Bhuya. I want to be servant of your lotus feet. Suppose God is asking, being servant of servant, what he will do? Manas marit asupatir gunanam. How asupati means the husband of this, the master of life, that means Krishna. My mind will remember you. You are my master of life. Manas marit asupatir grinita bhak karma karo tu kaya.
Aspate is Sambodhan.
Oh
Prananath.
Oh Prananath.
Then
that means
my mind should always remember you.
My mind must remember you. And Granita Bhak Karma Karo Tukaya. By speech I shall glorify you and by body I shall serve you. Then so God became
Nanaka Pristam Nacha
Param. God was satisfied, then he again praying. Nanaka Pristam Napa Nacha Paramestam Nasarva Bhomam Narasadhipattam Najoga Siddhi Rapunar Bhavamba Samanja Satvavirahaja Kanche Nanaka Pristam. God is telling you can take heavenly planet, kingdom of heavenly planet. No, Prabhu, I don't want. You want more? Nanaka Pristam Nacha Sarva Bhaumam.
Why he does not Why he did not want this?
Because Nanaka Prishtam, if someone go to heavenly planet, he have to come again this material world. Because chine punne martalo kang bisanti, when our past activity will be finished, we have to come again this material world in the chain of birth and death. So he don't want. Nasarva bhaumam, emperor of this material world, well, I don't want. Why not? Because the material world is full of suffering and sorrows and distress. So I don't want. Rasadhipattam, kingdom of Patal Lok. There is
like
more,
Bali Maharaj.
Like Bali Maharaj. There is more opulence than this material world. There is 14 loks in this planet. Bhu, Bhuva, Maha, Jana, Tapa, Satya. Gradually, more and more opulence from Bhulok to Bhuvalok, from Bhuvalok to Satyalok, gradually up to Satyalok. And in down lok, Atal, Bital, Sutal, Talatal, Mahatal, Rasatal, Patal. Gradually also more and opulence downstairs, down lokas. Bali Maharaj Sutalok. After that, Mahatal, Rasatal, but three loks more in down. So, you know, no Rasadhipattam, I don't want. Because there is also always suffering and sorrows, they will quarrel each other. There is no sadhan bhajan. So I don't want to go there also being a master of Rasadhipattam, Patallok. Na yoga siddhi, then you can take yoga siddhi, anima, laghima, mahima, anything. Well, I don't want. It is also not for permanent happiness. Only some temporary happiness, only for sukh, not ananda there. Apunar bhavamba, to mukti lelo apunar bhavamba, tad no punar bhavam, if there is no birth. Punar bhavam means again birth and birth again and again. Apunar bhavam, no birth. That means mukti. You can take mukti, no prabhu, I don't want. Because in Bhagavatam, diyamanam api na grinnanti vinamat sevanam jana. If God want to do salvation for any devotee, the prabhu, we don't want. So, Dhritarashtra also telling, no, I don't want this apunar bhavam. You are qualified to give anything, I don't want. I want only virahajya kanche, I want to feel your separation. Then how, when they will come, then I can serve you eternally.
No. I want to serve only. Accept this, I don't want to accept anything that you have told.
Accept your service, I don't want anything, which I told us before.
Yeah, virahaya means giving, accept this.
Tyag karke sir. Then he is again praying, ajata pakshaiva mataram khaga stannam yatha vatsatara achudartha priyang priyeva busitam busanna manurabinda saddik satetam ajata pakshaiva mataram khaga. Oh God, I want to pray like a wingless bird. When a baby bird, that mother came keep them in nest, went for their
food supply.
That ajata paksha, the wing, that baby bird always remember for his mother. When mother will come feed me and I will be free from fear. Then maybe vulture come and I will come take me, but when mother will come, she will protect me. She always remember his mother. Vitas is telling, I don't like to pray like baby bird. Then ajat matra stannam jatha vatsatara achudartha. Then like a calf, he always praying for his mother. Mother went for grazing. When milkman will bring his mother, he is waiting for his mother always, mooing for his mother. As soon as he saw his mother, he began to laugh, he want to jump and want to go to his mother. Milkman want to untie this rope and want to free from rope, but he is so busy, want to go to mother immediate. And which way he want to go for mother satisfaction? No, for his own satisfaction, and want to go order of mother, not anywhere else. So here, that Cup is superior to baby bird because bird bring any insect from outside, not from his body. And here, cup is taking milk from his mother udder, which connected with her body. So it is more superior to baby bird. Then he not satisfied yet. At first only is remembering for mother, only remember. Here, kirtan and remembers more on both. He is remembering her, his mother, and mowing for his mother, that's like kirtan. So, at last he is telling, priyang priyeva busitang busanna manura brindaksa didik satetam. Apropo, I don't want to pray like this also. So what you like? Priyang priyeva busitang busanna. If there is a lover and beloved, if lover went far away from her beloved, then he came, only telegram came or phone call came, I am coming. Then she's always so worried, when he will come, always remembering. And he is glorifying his beloved, his lover, among his children, among his friends. Oh, he is so qualified, he has so many virtues, like this. Always he is telling. He is remembering and doing kirtan and glorifying when he will come. And when he'll come, he don't want for his own happiness. She wants to serve him and want to satisfy him. So in symptom of Srimad Bhagavatam, Vritrasura Badhapetam, one symptom of Srimad Bhagavatam must be there, Vritrasura Upakhan. So in this sloka, at first, for baby bird is remembering only and he wants his own satisfaction, not his mother's satisfaction. And second, the calf, he also wants his own satisfaction, but connected with his mother. And in third, a Shravan Kirtan Smaran, three are here. And she don't want his own satisfaction, she wants to satisfy him, his lover. Here not mentioned husband or wife, poti and stri, but priyang priyeva. There is more lovely connection between priya and priya. In husband and wife, their relation is not so broad. But here, relation between priya and priya, it is so high. So in Srimad Bhagavatam, in Paramar mood, the gopis loves Krishna as their priya among priya and priya. So in this focus, it hints the mood of gopis, paramar mood, gopis towards Krishna. Okay. After that he is again praying. Mamottama sloka janesu.
Thank you.
Have you clearly understood? Govind Bhagat, tell what he told in very brief.
So the Vritrasura Prabhu was explaining the prayer by Vritrasura Muni.
What is the purport?
The purport is that there are three different relationships which were explained. The first is the baby bird, which...
Why only three examples? Why? Why three? Because he has promised three things. What?
Manasmarit. Agnit vaka ar karma karotu kaya.
We have only three things: body, mind and tongue to do anything. So he has prayed to God, Supreme Personality of Godhead, that I want to pray you that my mind should be always engaged in meditating you, first thing. Then, grinita vako, always my tongue should be engaged in chanting name, glorifying Krishna, telling pastimes of Krishna. And karma karotu kayaha, that my body should always be engaged in serving you. Three things. For three things he is giving example. My mind should always meditate you like a baby bird who has no wings. His mother, their mothers have gone to pick up, collect some
grain
or anything for them. Now the boys, children, those who have no wings at all, they are meditating his mother. Oh, when mother will come? When mother, always waiting very eagerly. By two reasons. If their mothers will come, then they will have something to eat. And without this, they will die. And secondly, they are so fearing from other crows and other birds, owls. If her mother is absent there, they will at once take and take it. So he is also fearing. So they are always meditating her mother, that when mother will come, when mother will come, waiting eagerly. But they cannot adore anything. So I want to always meditate you in our mind. But telling this, he began to think, there are something lacking in this. Only selfishness is there. Only to take something and to remove his
fears,
he is chanting. Oh, should I do in the same way to Krishna? No, I don't want. But I should remember just as baby birds, always. Oh, where mother will come? When Krishna will come? We should try to always eagerly waiting for Krishna. With utakantha. Then, but he saw that there are some defect. I should not be like that birds. But only one thing, always eagerly, eager is there. I should take it. Not other things, selfishness. Then he told second thing. What second thing? Baksha tarachudhartha. Cow's cough. When mother goes to graze in fields here and there whole day, he is waiting. But when some darkness becomes to come and evening coming, his eagerness so high. Then he begins to do da-da, like?
Mowing.
Very eagerly, and mowing also. So mowing is like kirtanam. Smaranam was first like
meditation
like baby. That and this is like cough. That he's doing also. Oh, when mother will come? Oh, mother, come on. And here he wants to call Krishna. Oh, Krishna, hey Nath, Ramana, Preshta, Kwashi Mahabhuja, Kripanaya, Dasyaste, Kripanaya, Sakhe,
Darsaya
Sannidhi. Oh, Krishna, oh Nath, you should come at once. I will die if you are not coming. So Kirtan is like that. And also meditating like that. But he also reminded himself that, oh, there is some loop and hole. I want to cry like that Gobatsa cough. But not his selfishness. He only crying for milk. Only crying. The birds will take anything and give to their childs outside of their bodies. But cows will give milk from his own ord and supporting these calves. So calf is only crying and meditating for his selfness, that mother will come and save me, giving my milk. So he rejected these examples also. He took only two things from them. From only meditate from that, and cow's buck off,
crying.
Two, crying and meditating both. And thirdly, he took the example of any beloved. If any beloved is very far away, then a chaste wife always meditating when he will come, when eagerly. And sometimes he glorifies, oh, why he could not come? I know that he has so much love and affection for me. He knows that I cannot leave. He is so merciful. He supports me. So, also,
Kirtan
also, meditating also, and one thing that there is nowhere in two examples. What was that?
For his
selfless love and affection. So he wanted like this. Like when he will come to home, his wife will give sweet water, delicious food, and very affectionate, loving, talking something. Like mother also, like servant, and moreover like beloveds. So here he is telling, like this. So this is a symptoms like gopi somewhat. So this Chitraketu Maharaj, that his prayer is more higher than Prahlad, even other bhakts. So there, so important. Now he is telling. So he lastly he is praying. Mamat tamas lok janesu sakhyam. I am not qualified to do these three things. I cannot meditate like that.
Baby bird.
Selfless. Not like calf. I do kirtan. I cannot do kirtan like him. And meditate both. Not like a chaste lady or beloved lady. Three things doing. Chanting, waiting eagerly. Nainam galadashudharaya badanam gadagadaruddhayagira. Kulikar nechitam vapuh kadato nam grahanivasya. Oh, I cannot do it because I have no love and affection for Krishna. So he is telling that, oh, I am unqualified for all these things. Only wants very simple things. Mamattama shloka janesu sakhyam sansara chakre brahmateshva karnavi. By my sinful activities and good activities, if I am taking birth and again death, this chain of birth repeatedly, a cycle of birth and death, and in that I am suffering from so many things, so many rogues, so many problems, but yet I pray you that I should have a birth near to any devotee. And I have a friendship, I should have a friendship to that devotee. Tanmayato atmaja dargehesu asakta chittasya na nath me bhuyat. O Nath, you are qualified to give anything, you have power to give anything. But I want simply this thing, that in this world, if I have come, if my birth is there, then I have some friendship with any pure devotee. O Nath, O Lord, I want that you should have a benediction that your maya, illusory maya is so powerful, so covered by this, controlled by this maya, I should not be attached to my family, my children, my wife, my
house,
all opulence, anything, very beautiful gardens, dogs, cows or anything. No? You should take my this thing and I should have a friendship, always association of that devotee I want. By this, three things will gradually come. And seeing that, Krishna did so much mercy to him. And this was because he was Chitraketu himself in his past life. And Chitraketu, anyhow, he had the association of Narada and Parvata Rishi. And by that, he left his home, his so much attraction for his only one son of 5 years, and he put to death. He was given poison, and he was dead. And he was crying bitterly with his whole family. Narada and they came, and they pacified them. And they advised that you should do bhajan to Shankarshan. And they began to do, and quickly they were liberated from this world. So we should try to be like that, Chitraketu Maharaj. Our today class is now.
Maharaj, ye bhakti mitrata se tino cheeze kaun si, smaran, kirtan aur shravan ya sneh?
Kya? तीन चीज बताया ना, मन के द्वारा स्मरण, जीवा के द्वारा उनका गुण कीर्तन और बॉडी के द्वारा सेवा, तीन चीज।
In this example, first that baby bird example is only for
meditating.
Meditation. And the second calf example is for meditation.
Both meditating and kirtan.
Kirtan. And third one is
body. By body, he's keeping cold water, preparation so much, having love, having so much, many three things are there, by bodily also.
So this bodily service is in Navada Bhakti, this bodily service, this service with love and affection is one of the nine processes of...
Where?
Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu.
All are including this.
This is Atmanivedanam.
Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam.
Atmanivedanam.
Is this Atmanivedanam?
What?
This bodily service, love and affection?
No.
Then it's
by serving body. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Smaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Bandhanam, Dasyam, Dasyam.
This is Dasyam.
It will come.
It appears, Maharaj, that in the first prayer he has set his aim and objective. In the second prayer, where he said,
in first he has prayed for three things, and by three examples he is giving all these things. So how?
And in the last he is asking for the sadhana.
Sadhana.
Yes. First he has fixed the sadhya, then he is talking about the sadhana.
Gaur Praman. I think that there is going to be drama. There should be. Ready? You can.
If Srila Prabhupada says that Yamaraj is a pure devotee, so if these Yamadutas are serving Yamaraj, are they making any advancement at all?
मुझे जमराज बोलन
ये कह रहे हैं महाराज जी कि यमराज महाजनों में से हैं, भगवान के परम भक्त हैं और यमदूत यमराज की सेवा कर रहे हैं. महाजनों की सेवा करने से क्या यमदूतों की उन्नति होगी?
भक्ति में
उन्नति होगी उनकी क्या? क्योंकि वो यमराज की सेवा कर रहे हैं और यमराज महाजनों में से एक
हैं. इफ यमराज हैज सम मर्सी देन दे कैन डू लाइक दैट, अदरवाइज नो. इफ दे आर चैंटिंग नेम they do that, doing their activities, if they are glorifying Krishna, doing all these things, then Jam will be very satisfied. Because he has told them that those who are chanting Hari name, you should not go to them. So you should also chant Hari name. You should also remember, you should do all the activities. So he is telling also these teachings to them. And if they are following, then they will come in the line of bhakti, otherwise not.
And secondly, Maharaj, those who do the sinful activities and they are taken by the Yamdut, they go to the hellish planets.
What?
जो जिसको यमदूत लेके जाते हैं यमराज के पास ये वो लोग होते हैं जिन्होंने ऐसे कर्म किए हैं दैट दे विल गो टू हेल नॉट नॉट में
नो 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 नॉट दिस में गुड एंड बैड बोथ दे टेक एस्पेशली वेरी बैड पर्सन्स बट दे कैन टेक इजीली देम हु हैज डन वेरी पॉयस थिंग्स एंड ही विल सेंड हिम देम टू स्वर्ग But all should come to Jambaraj. But for them, those who are sinful, they will crush there. They will beat with koda. Koda, you know?
Whip.
They will cut by anything weapon. Come on. They will give no arrangement for coming there.
No mercy.
No mercy. Cruel, with cruel hearted they will. Dragging them.
And when a living entity goes into the same species like आदमी से आदमी बनता है ऐसे कर्म में जो बीच के तब भी क्या पहले वो यम लोग जाएगा
तब कुछ जरूर वो सब बहुत से इसके फॉर्मूला
से those who are sent to स्वर्ग लोग by यमदूतास those यमदूत
are not by
यमराज
यमराज then who comes to take the soul यमदूतास or
no.
यमराज
no. himself there a special विमान comes
Beautiful, not as fierce as this
Yes. Like Harishchandra, a special Biman came.
Airplane.
Arranged by Yamraj.
A special kinds of Duta. So many cruel, so many goats, Duta of Dharmaraj, like that.
Gurudev, you were saying about different names, how Vishnu and Ram is one side and Krishna is the other. What is the name of Jagannath? Is that also... If one Secondary. Remembers Jagannath.
Jagannath, who supports this world? Is Jagannath. This Jagat.
This material world.
In Puri they have Jagannath. So if one remembers that Jagannath, then
we You should think that your Jagannath, who is Jagannath? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Jagannath is himself Brajendranandan. But your Jagannath of Dwarkadhish or of this world? Satyabhama Rukmini Jagannath is Dwarkadhish. But for a general person, he is Jagannath, he is...
Part of the universe.
Whole universe.
So with which heart you remember, then it becomes Jagannath of Vrindavan.
What?
If you remember Jagannath like how Mahaprabhu remembered,
then,
Sham Sudra, then that's different.
Then I will not tell, oh Jagannath Prabhu, oh Jagannath Prabhu. I will, oh Brajendranandan, oh Radhanath, Radhakanta, like this.
But Mahaprabhu, sometimes he was saying jag in a choking voice.
Because he is teaching all, general mass, not to Rai Ramananda he is telling, to Sarup Damodar, to Rupa Goswami. He is telling his different kinds of teachings to different kinds of devotees, not for all.
So when he was saying jag, it was just to the common people?
Yes.
And Maharaj, that is why he was not saying Jagannath. It is stuck in his mouth.
Oh, is that why he can't?
Yeah. That is why he's chopped. And if Brajendranandan, ha, Radhe, 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 Krishna, not chopped.
Like.
Tricky answer. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Thank you. fell when she was hurt. She got hurt. She took her something. Then, maybe, Mr.
always gain what you want.
all his suffering and sorrow and all kinds of troubles will go away. So Krishna Nam is so powerful. Now he should sprinkle his mercy in his spiritual. Gaur Prema. Shri Krishna Chaitanya.
Shri Krishna Chaitanya. Prabhu
Nityananda.
Prabhu Nityananda.
Shri Advaita Gadadha.
Shri Advaita Gadadha.
Shri Adi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda.
Shri Gaur Bhakta Vrinda.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Ram, Hare Ram.
Hare Ram, Hare Ram.
After millions and millions of births, I mean, understanding all of the absolute knowledge, it still may not be possible to attain liberation. Yet he thinks that simply by a glimpse of
liberation. In all revealed scriptures, it describes that one achieves liberation.
Yes. If one cannot attain liberation by an avos, then I will certainly.
Hiranya and Govardhan both immediately chastised the Brahmin tax collector. He consoled him, saying that this is none of your fault. Pure Vaishnava never takes anyone's insults seriously. This teaching of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Trinadapi Suniche Na, and fingers were beautiful like golden colored champaka buds. Being the condition of Gopal Chakravarti, everyone was astonished. in such a suffering condition. But everyone was a Vaishnava. He did not take seriously the Brahmin's offense. But the Supreme Personality of Godhead could not tolerate it, and thus he made the Brahmin suffer the consequences. Please be aware of the mad elephant offense and the pure devotee of the Lord. Hare Krishna.
Devotee.